Hey guys, welcome to my non-Instagram nursery tour. I've not actually shown any of you how we've set the nursery up, and we actually just finished decorating it like a couple of months ago. Yes, Bubs is almost 9 months old. Anyhow, I wanted to just go through a few of the things, some of the stuff we've got, how we've decorated it, and just show you some of the real functioning and things about how we've kind of got it all set up. This nursery is like the opposite of an Instagram nursery. It's very functional. When I was looking up nursery designs and, like, you know, how to pair them together and everything like that, I very much felt like there was this pressure to make it just this outstanding Instagram version of a nursery, you know, and it didn't feel very, like, practical to me. I mean, how is that practical for a baby, if that makes sense? They don't care if it looks good for Instagram. Anyhow, I just thought it'd be helpful for any new mums out there, especially, just to show you guys some of the things that I've done. I mean, I do have a few little kind of, you know, pieces, decorations and stuff that maybe is just purely decoration, but this is a very functional room and I have made it as cozy as I possibly can so that I kind of feel really at home in this room. In fact, this room is now my favorite room in the whole house. Anyway, just in case you're new, my name is Charlie. I am a first-time mum. As I said before, my Bubs is almost 9 months old now. I am British and I live in Australia. And yeah, that's about it. So let's jump straight in. So straight out, this is the nursery. One of the first things I actually bought was this kind of rotating swivel chair that comes with its own little footstool. I just wanted something that was big and cozy that would fit both me and Bubs, and, you know, when Lexi grows up and we can both sit on that chair and read stories together. And I just wanted something that was, like, really, really wide and big and cozy. And to be honest, me, Tom and Lexi can fit on that chair and sort of sit and read a bedtime story together. We got her name blocks. Bubs is called Alexis. Very big on nicknames, I think, because I have a lot of nicknames. And as you'll know, that we actually call her Lexi. So I just wanted to have good nicknames, and then I guess when she gets a little bit older, she might also be called Alex, because I really like the name for a girl. I think it's really cute. Anyway, and then I got these really cute wooden decorations that says be brave. So this was kind of, yeah, I guess this is a little bit Instagram, but you know, I got this from IKEA. You might have noticed already that the theme of the nursery, well, the theme and the colour scheme is grey and teal and a splash of pink, but adventure. So before I get to this, I'll explain this in a second. We have a grow egg that tells you the temperature of the room. As you can see, a little bit hot today. So this turns colour when the temperature gets too warm, but otherwise it just kind of sits at amber or yellow and green. And then a new purchase that I got just the other day is a Yuki Bear. This is a diffuser, sound machine, and nightlight. We don't actually use the nightlight, we do use the sound machine. Lexi's favorite sound at the moment is... water running. She likes that one. We've been using Yuki Bear oil to make the room smell really nice. And this was very, very kindly painted for us by Tom's auntie Trish, and it's actually an abstract painting of the River Murray. What I think is fantastic is that it starts up obviously in the Riverland area and then comes down to the mouth. And Lexi was obviously conceived in Bury and then was born here in Victor Harbour. So it's kind of like the story of her so far. And I just thought it was so beautiful when she offered to paint this, and I was like, oh my goodness, I would absolutely adore that. This is just some wooden, like, stencil cutouts that I got off Etsy, I think it was, and then I spray painted them in my colors. We've got these beautiful little quotes in frames on the wall here as well. But again, I got that collection from Etsy. I'm very keen on supporting, you know, small artists on Etsy because I think it's a great thing to do. Okay, so this is why I said that it's not a very Instagrammable nursery. I have just, you know, her clothes out in a rack just here and like some storage stuff. I have Lexi's clothes hanging up here and also in this cupboard here. I've basically just, I've hung up a few outfits that I'm, you know, that I use on a regular basis. I created my own little coat hanger dividers. I actually designed that myself and then just like laminated it because they seem to be, they're all just a little bit generic and they're all just like the same sort of wooden ones and I couldn't find any I liked and I just thought, you know what, this was the design that I had for my my bump milestones, so I just thought, well, why not just create my own? So I've got these that I've done and put in place, and then I just have a few of like, well, I have a few of the clothes that she's wearing at the moment. How cute is this little one? It's so cute. That, and like this little dress. It's very, very cute. Anyway, I'm obviously not going to go through all of Lexi's clothes right now. But this is the next size up, ready to go. Then I've also been collecting clothes in the sales because, you know, you've got to get things when you can. For instance, like, you know, I've got that for like $6. That's not too bad, hey? $5 and $3, got some clothes, got a little hoodie for her, so be cute. If you are a like long-term subscriber and you saw we got this little outfit at the markets, you know, if you know, you know. So that one was a special outfit. Anyhow, yeah, I've got a few of her clothes on here. That is her laundry basket, so we put all of her clothes in one laundry basket and we wash it together. This is everything I've been putting together for Lexi's scrapbook. You guys will know I absolutely adore doing scrapbooks. I am going to be showing some more of my scrapbooks, I think, on this channel. And then this box here is Lexi's baby box. I'll maybe show you what's in that at some point because it's also quite fun. It's like some of the stuff from hospital. And then this is just toys. We do like a toy rotation so that she, you know, doesn't get bored of toys. Just quickly before we move on, I want to show you something really, really awesome. For my baby shower, one of our friends' mums made us the most, oh, they're just spectacular, made these little dungarees for when she's a little bit bigger. How cute is this? But look at the print. It is Disney. Look at how cute this is. She especially imported this material from America. She also made me a nappy bag. Obviously, this nappy bag is way too good to use as a nappy bag. Anyhow, again, she imported this print from America. This is all Disney World snacks. And this is all just like other snacks. And I think it's Australian. I think this is Australian snacks and this is Disney snacks. But look how beautiful this is and look at the detail on this. Look at even this, like there's little Disney on the rainbow zip here. So beautiful. As I said, definitely not using this as a nappy bag. This is just way too special. But I just was completely blown away about how beautiful that was. Anyway, let's carry on. This sign was made for me by my friends for my surprise baby shower. I had no idea they were throwing me a baby shower. It was just, I don't think anyone has ever actually surprised me before. I was completely blown away. So that was just so special. And one of my best friends at home made this for Lexi and she has written a really cute little note that's for Lexi on the back as well. So I'm keeping that especially for her. Obviously we've got our milestone blocks. We're going to be changing this over soon to 9 months. This, as you can obviously see from the theming of most of the nursery, it's travel, is a little hot air balloon. How cute is that? So I'm going to hang this from, I'm not quite sure where yet, I might hang it from the curtain rails. Look at the little basket. Look at that detail. It's so unbelievably cute. Again, I got this on Etsy. And
yeah, just a little bit of cuteness. And I don't know, something about hot air balloons, it's very cute, isn't it?
I've got a little bit of pirate here, and a little bit of Australia. I was burning a candle in here before just to make it smell nice. I have most of her clothes in these drawers, and yes, they are labelled up, and that is for Tom, because, you know, I just wanted to make sure he knew where everything was, and it was very easy to just to grab stuff out. So I have all of the things that we're using at the moment in these drawers, then, and the bottom one is all of the clothes for the next size up. So if she suddenly starts, you know, suddenly just goes into the next size up, they're ready. I'm obviously not going to go through all of these drawers, but look at these cute little sunglasses. I have quite a few little cute bows and things like that, but we very rarely use anything like that. It's kind of crazy. Again, with the bibs, we don't use a lot of the bibs anymore, but I have a fair few of those. This is your Instagram versus reality. This is the reality. Literally, I don't ever roll up these or fold them. It's just, this is just how they are. So this is all her sleep suits, and this is like short onesies, and then little kind of tops and singlets and her swimwear. This is all of her main sort of clothes. I got these the other day. They're super cute. Just little leggings, and we've got a lot of little ruffle kind of nappy cover pants and just some jumpers and stuff. But yeah, that's I'm actually probably going to take the labels off these now, because, well, Tom knows what's going on now. It's been a while, he knows what's going on. And this is my favorite feature of the whole of the nursery. I absolutely obsessed with books, as you can tell. We've got like all different types. We've got like the nerd, like proper just like story books, but we've also got lots of kind of touchy-feely books, and just, yeah, we've got the whole range. We've got some ones from when I was little. This one is, yeah, one of my favorites when I was little. And we've got some just beautiful, one of my best friends gave me this, a personalized book. And yeah, we've just got a kind of a good like range of books that's probably going to last for like the next, well, 3 or 4 years, to be honest. But I was very keen to have a bookshelf that was on the floor so that she can come up and like pick her own books and everything. So I just thought, I really like this design, so you can just see all the books really clearly. And yeah, something about that. Lamp is probably going to go. I don't really know what I'm doing with that lamp yet. It's just there at the moment. But yeah, this is the cot. So we actually got this cot secondhand from like just a family down the road in a garage sale for $20. Can you believe it? $20. I mean, it's pretty perfect. There's a few scratches on it, but I mean, who really cares? The baby doesn't care. We obviously bought a brand new mattress that's like really nice and firm, and that's all kind of brand new. Everything is brand new apart from that. But yeah, doesn't matter. And I really like this cot. It has drop sides on it. So this is dropped down at the moment, but this then comes up. And it also had two levels. We did have it higher before, but Lexi has started kind of pulling herself up, so we now have to drop it right down. Again, ignore the fact we've just got a sleep suit hanging over that, but you know, this is real. This is not Instagram. We have this really lovely kind of, I don't really know what you call this print, but it's kind of like travel-y because it's arrows. And then obviously we've got this mountain themed mobile with the little bears. They're super cute. I have two last things on the wall. Obviously, Alexis, a name there, and then follow your dreams. And this was given to me on my baby shower as well, which is really sweet. So that's a canvas. We've got Tom's didgeridoo in the corner there. That's obviously gonna have to go at some point. I'm not really sure what's going on there, but it's still here apparently. And then the change table. Now, originally I was like, we don't actually need a change table, but actually it's been super helpful because we just wheeled this into the living room at one point when we pretty much had her just everything in the living room because it was just easier. I've actually really loved it because it's got so much storage underneath. So I have everything accessible. I have her nappies right here ready to grab. I have her wipes. We have like the bum cream just there. Hand sanitizer. I do have, at the moment I just have like a cover on, but when we have guests around or well, when she was little, and you know, there used to be a lot of accidents, we would use a change cover. I have a couple of disposable ones, but I also have ones that you just throw in the wash. And we've got like swim nappies. We basically just have everything there. I've got my burp towels and all the spare nappies and spare wipes, and it's just all accessible and just really very easy. This is the distraction toy. She's got to that age now where it's quite impossible to change her nappy without giving a little bit of distraction, so we give her that to play with. Okay, this is another thing that's kind of a little bit ridiculous. Our friends gave us this beautiful pocket trailblazer coloured or themed macrame plant hanger, except that we have the baby camera hanging from it so that it can like see the cot. So we've kind of basically got like this angle on there because it's, you know, we've got nowhere else to put it, and just works fine. So that's what's happening there at the moment. So again, not very Instagrammable, I know, but that's just how it is, and it functions. The very last thing in this nursery is this little nightlight that says, "A dream is a wish your heart makes."
I obviously had to have a little bit of Disney in the nursery. If I had my way, I would also have some beautiful like Disney quotes or some castles put up on the walls as well. But you know, we had to be a little bit restrained because I can't just cover the walls and everything. Anyway, if you've made it this far, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed seeing our little nursery and all the little bits and bobs, and I hoped it was like functional and like helped you out, you know, or maybe gave you some ideas about what you'd like to do for your nursery. Again, do not let the pressure get to you of being like, I have to get the nursery perfect, because you really don't. Having said that, our little Bobs is just about ready for a nap. So yeah, baby girl is about to go down for a little nap, aren't you? Thank you so much for watching. Please hit the subscribe button and please hit the like button and share this with any mamas that you think it might help, or if they might just like to see, you know. And if you are due soon, then I wish you the best of luck with your bubs and, you know, getting your nursery set up. And this one's just gonna pull. She's in the pulling hair stage. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys soon. Bye.